I'm Jennifer Smart, and we're here in Hollywood for Radio Disney's NBT Kickoff Concert. Have you given any advice to these NBT artists since you've gone through it yourself?
I have given a lot of advice. One thing that I always did when I was on NBT was I was very myself. I never tried to change myself. I wanted everybody to know who I was. And so I told them, everybody just really stick to who you are and be yourself, and people will enjoy that and like that about you.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
Favorite music artists? I'd have to say I really like Taylor Swift's new album, Brandy, Justin Bieber. I could honestly name a lot of people.
You're performing today. What is your favorite song to perform live?
Favorite song is actually one of my new songs called Party Young, which you guys will hear soon because my album comes out next year and singles are dropping this November, so you guys have got to check it out.
What is the best thing about performing with siblings and a best friend?
I think the best part is we can all agree on certain things, but when we don't agree, it's not like we're hiding it. We just tell them, like, no, dude, that's not cool. Yeah, we're straight up with each other. We trust each other, and we respect each other's opinions, and we get to the point a lot faster than other bands would.
Definitely.
Basically everything. It's so much fun being with this crazy boys.
And, like, you're kind of like stuck together, because like that's what everyone kind of says. Like, we can't really break up as a band because we're related, you know, except for him. Maybe we'll kick him out later.
I don't think any of us want to break up, though.
Yeah, I mean, so... And I don't know, I like it.
My favorite thing is just being able to do, you know, what I love more than anything in the world with my best friends.
Aww. Yes.
And these are like the brothers and sister that I've never had because I'm an only child. So it's like, best
pretty,
of both worlds.
Pretty much related.
That's right.
Yeah.
He's related, but just not blood related.
How would you describe your music?
Oh man, I'll describe my music as like trying to reach everybody, like because I grew up listening to a lot of different kind of music, so I want like everybody to be able to like understand my music and be able to like dance and jump and sing to it. So that's pretty much how I describe my music.
What is your favorite song to perform live?
My favorite song to perform live, it has to be like this thing that I put together. I call it my oldies melody. I put like a lot of different like songs from the past together, and I collage it together. It's really, really fun because I at a certain point, I just grabbed the mic. I'm like, I feel good, and I started dancing, so that's really cool, yeah.
How would you describe your music?
My music is pop, it's soul, it's country, it's a little bit of everything, definitely, yeah.
What is your favorite song to perform live?
Oh gosh, my original Soul is my favorite thing ever to perform because it's just fun and kids are starting to know it now because it's on Radio Disney, so just to see kids singing with it is like crazy.
How is LA different from where you're originally from?
Well, I'm from New York, so they're kind of polar opposites. New York's more like busy, 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 everyone's doing their own thing, and then LA's everyone's just really chill and doing their own, like kind of just laid back and stuff.
What is your favorite song to perform live?
I love Good Girl by Carrie Underwood, and I also love singing my original song, Day Away.
How is LA different from where you're originally from?
Well, I'm from New York City, so I love New York City because everyone is so creative and not scared to be themselves, and LA is just so much fun. I actually, today, when we were about to perform, like for sound check, I was looking out and I was like, I haven't seen the Hollywood sign, and then someone tells me to turn around, and then there's like right there, and I'm like, ah, this is so cool. LA is so much fun.
How would you describe your music?
I like to call my music vintage pop. You know, I mix pop with rock and roll. The 50s and 60s are where most of my heaviest influences come from. So, yeah, if I had to give it a title, it's vintage pop.
What is your favorite song to perform live?
I love playing new songs to crowds, trying things out, see what people think of them. I think that's the feeling I like the most when I'm performing.
How would you describe your music?
Well, we sing like a little bit of everything, but we're very pop and R&B kind of mixed together, and we just love to sing. It's
okay. We love all different types of music.
What is your favorite song to perform live?
Our favorite song to perform live would probably have to be our single, TMI. It's just such a fun song, and everybody starts dancing to it, and it makes you feel really good. So TMI, our original song, would have to be one of our favorite songs.
How is LA different from where you're originally from?
LA is so much
so
different
much fun.
From Atlanta.
Yes.
Like, you see palm trees and
glitz and glam.
And
stuff.
Now that it's fall, like, it's getting colder in Atlanta, but it's, like, warm in LA.
So. Yeah. I wish I lived here.
Have you given any advice to these NBT artists since you went through it yourself?
Yeah, I have. Actually, I was a mentor for this season, which was really new and, like, exciting for me. It was definitely a different perspective, and I tried to share, you know, my past experiences, obviously, because, you know, I kind of went through it. So, but that was really fun, and they seemed to, you know, take it into consideration, so it was really fun.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
Oh my goodness. Taylor Swift is my favorite in the entire world. Like, I love her so much. But I love Adele and, let's see, I love Demi Lovato. I went to her concert a couple of weeks ago and it was amazing, but yeah.
What's next for you?
Well, I've been writing a lot of new music, so hopefully maybe like an EP or something along the lines of, you know, an EP or an album, maybe dream big, but but I've definitely been writing a lot, so hopefully something like that coming up.
Tell us about my life as an NBA rookie.
My life as an NBA rookie, basically, sorry, I have to laugh. Basically,
you're not an NBA rookie. We know that.
No, I'm nowhere near tall enough. I mean, don't get me wrong. I got the NBA skills. I'm just not tall enough. I'm working on it. I've been stretching lately. Yeah. But my life as an NBA rookie, basically what it is I'm a goofball through the whole thing. And I give you insight sort of into what it's like into the life of an NBA rookie. The daily things that they go through. The people that they meet, how they are treated by their fellow NBA team members, and it's just, it's a lot of fun, you know what I mean? Because a lot of people don't think about that, you know, what it's like to be an NBA rookie. They think, oh, I love Dwayne Wade, you know, just like the big guys. But the rookies are those, you know, soon to be NBA All-Star sort of like bigger than life, larger than life, you know, basketball players. So that's basically what I show you guys in a very goofy, over-the-top way.
Billy Unger kind of
Billy Unger, yeah. I put my own little Billy Unger spin on it. But that's why it's fun.
What is something that fans would be surprised to learn about you?
I'm an open book. There isn't much that people don't know about me. At least I like to think that. Yeah. I don't have any, like... You know, I don't have any, like, weird things to tell people when they ask me that question. They ask me, what's something really weird maybe that people don't know about you? I got nothing. I'm just, you know, a rocker. I play guitar and I act. And I love to have a good time with my friends and I love my family. And so, yeah. And I love this girl, too. This one.
Who are some of your favorite current music artists?
Guns N' Roses will always be at the top of my list. But I love Led Zeppelin. Just two nights ago, actually, I went and saw the Jason Bonham Led Zeppelin Experience. And they kind of do this thing where they come to LA once a year, and they were at the Greek Theater. And the coolest part of the entire concert was that when their guitarist was delivering a Jimmy Page solo, a shooting star flew right over. And everyone just kind of, like, their eyes went straight to this, like, shooting star. And I was in awe. It was really pretty magical, as quirky as that sounds.
And we also just saw you on Glee. How was that experience?
Glee was amazing. I had so much fun. I worked with Lea Michele, and it was so fun. I mean, of course, I played the mean girl again. Really, I am nice in real life, honestly. But, you know, it's so much fun. I love playing the mean girl because, you know, it gives me something to really grasp onto as an actor.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
Music artists. I love Taylor Swift. I mean, who doesn't? I love Katy Perry. I love Kelly Clarkson. Carly Rae Jepsen, of course. One Direction. You can't not love One Direction. I love Lady Antebellum. So another one of my favorites. But yeah, I mean, the list goes on. I can't even name them all.
Tell us about the song Smile.
Well, it just came out today. It's a great song, basically about finding that one thing in life that makes you smile, and when you can use that to your highest power, it makes, you know, it makes really, it really makes it contagious. and then everybody around you starts smiling, and it's just one big happy planet, so.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
I have to say Taylor Swift. I always loved Christina Aguilera's music, because I just have, you know, a voice that's very similar to hers.
What is something that fans would be surprised to learn about you?
Something fans would learn to be surprised about me. I used to walk on my toes when I was little. I was like a toe walker, so I'd walk through the hallways in like elementary school and middle school and be like this. Everywhere I went. Very embarrassing.
I don't like roller coasters. I'm actually very scared of roller coasters, but I'm more than welcome to get on all the baby rides at the theme parks. As long as it doesn't go in the air or drop, I'm good. I know, and I'm going to try to get out of that. We're planning a trip to Disneyland soon, and I'm going to try to face my fear.
We'll do it.
Yes, we'll see.
What can people expect from this new season of Austin and Ally?
I haven't read any of the scripts. I haven't.
you haven't?
I haven't. We filmed it. I haven't looked at it. This season of Austin and Ally has a lot of great music, a lot of great comedy. There's a budding romance that happens, which is going to be a big shocker, I think. And I think just a really great season. It's a really solid season this year.
Yeah, I think he pretty much said it all. I mean, more crazy shenanigans, obviously. More Trish Jobs. She can never find that perfect job. She's still searching. And you know what? Just taking Austin's career to the next level.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
Ooh, I love Jessie J. One Direction's fun. Just everything. I kind of like everything right now. I'm always in everything.
I'm a diehard Ross fan. Ross Lynch. I'm obsessed with him. So
who is that?
He's on this show. It's really, really cool. It's weird that he's on our show, but we've never worked with each other. We've never met Ross before in our lives. They green screen him into
never.
The show. Yeah,
I know.
It's really
it's
fun.
It's really weird, yeah.
Yeah, it's like Avatar.
What can fans expect from the new season of Shake It Up?
Well, we expect a lot of changes. I mean, you've probably seen from like the trailers and stuff, you can see that Shake It Up Chicago burns down. So that kind of messes everything up for them, because you know, for Rocky and CeCe, Shake It Up Chicago is like, it's their dream. It's really what they only have really to hold on to, besides their friendship and family, of course, but it's so close to their hearts. So it's kind of, you know, throwing this big problem in the issue and the whole situation, and they have to learn to deal with it and figure out how to make the best out of this bad situation. So
what is something that fans would be surprised to learn about you?
They would be surprised to learn, I don't know, guys. I'm pretty open. I mean, there's not really many things that people don't know about me. Surprised to learn that I do not like syrup on my pancakes. Right? I hate syrup on my pancakes. Only butter. Oh, I hate syrup on my... Nope. Just nice melted butter. That's it. That's all I need. And whipped cream or Nutella.
What is your favorite kind of pancake?
Favorite kind of pancake? Chocolate chip. Anything chocolate, honestly. Thank you.
Who are some of your favorite music artists right now?
Favorite artists. Oh, gosh, that's hard. Honestly, I really love a lot of, you know, hip hop and rap. So, you know, definitely, you know, Kanye and all them, of course, are just awesome. But other than that, Rihanna's doing amazing. And of course, you know, there's like Cher Lloyd and stuff like that, which is really cool. And she was on our, you know, reality show for Make Your Mark, which is really cool. I didn't actually get to meet her, which is weird because she was right there, but I didn't get to meet her because I was running around. She was running around. But she looked really cool.
Congratulations, Chloe and Hallie, winners of NBT Season 5.